the CBS Easter Parade. I'm Susan Howard.
Lovely Donna Krebs of Dallas. Hi, I'm Ken Kercheval, alias Cliff Barnes, from where else? Dallas. You're getting double Dallas today.
And Ken, we definitely have to start meeting like this here, live on Fifth Avenue, in the heart of New York City.
The famous spot where people have been promenading in their Easter finery for over 100 years.
Idea of those past parades. Here's a rare look at the East Avenue, 1900.
They were still following that good old tradition here on Fifth Avenue in 1986. Flowers for the lovely lady.
Oh, thank you very much. And, Near for you.
Thanks. Happy Easter. I wish that had been for JR.
And now for a great new tradition that's taking the country by storm. Let's go to Orlando, Florida for Walt Disney World's Happy Easter Parade.
And Alicia from Falcon Crest and Robby Benson from Tough Cookies.
Happy Easter.
Hi. And I'm Wednesdays at 8:30, 7:30 Central.
Then I'm Fridays at 10 Eastern and 9 Central.
No, just kidding. I'm Tough Cookies. No, wait. I'm Robby Benson. And happy Easter. Welcome to what, well, may be the biggest, most colorful Easter celebration in America.
Walt Disney World is literally bursting with thousands of visitors.
And they're all lined up this morning to have breakfast with us.
And everybody's waiting to watch the big Easter parade, so come on and join the fun.
Welcome to the second annual CBS Easter Parade, a Nabisco Brands family presentation. Nabisco, who also brings you a parade of many fine products. Chips Ahoy cookies, Better Cheddars, Fleischmann's Light Spread, and America's wholesome snack cracker wheat thins. From the Nabisco family to your family, the second annual CBS Easter Parade, featuring the Walt Disney World Happy Easter Parade.
For those of you who may have just joined us, I'm Susan Howard with Ken Kercheval on New York's Fifth Avenue, going on with the second annual CBS Easter Parade.
Now, a few minutes ago, we showed you some amazing early film from the Easter Parade of 1900, but now we're going to go back and we're going to see the Easter Parade in 1940 during the Second World War.
Oh, that's great. Those hats are very in today.
Aren't they?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they are.
Very in. It's the netting, the oak.
Pretty lady.
You bet.
Pretty smile.
They're elegant hats.
They're lovely. They could be in shops today.
Think they had any zany hats down there?
Well.
Hey, that's an umbrella.
What is that? No, wait, is that a picture? That's a pretty hat.
Matching bag. Oh.
Hey.
Whatever could that
be? We've got some today. Oh, we've got some today. Just wait.
And speaking of zany hats, we'll have some of our own later. And we're also going to bring you a spring preview of bright summer fashions.
Now, back to Orlando.
Thanks. Hi, welcome back. Robby and I have here an ordinary run-of-the-nest size egg.
Yeah, but now look closely at this egg. Then compare it to this fabulous creation coming up in our parade.
The world's largest Easter egg. Doesn't it look great in all those fine spring colors?
Oh, yeah. And to give you some idea of its size, look at the hippos around it and the ostriches. The ostriches do pretty well in the egg department.
But nothing like this world's largest Easter egg. They tried to put that egg in the Guinness Book of Records, but they couldn't get the cover closed.
I'm sure you've been surprised Easter morning with a jolly Easter basket. But how about this one filled with all your favorite characters? Now try to keep track. There's Robin Hood, Maid Marian, Little John, J.R., Sue Ellen, and Angela Channing, Magnum P.I., Cliff Brady.
The three little pigs. The practical one who was concerned getting the most bricks in the market. There's Snow White and the seven dwarves. Look at those seven dwarves. Oh, look at those little pigs. Aren't they cute? Yeah. I knew they were there.
There's Jiminy Cricket, Geppetto, and of course, Pinocchio, whose nose got bigger every time he told a fib. Oh, there's the big bad wolf. Now, honey, Lyric, that's my little baby girl. Remember, the big bad wolf is really nice now.
I didn't know what
you were doing. Look at Peter Cottontail, up and down the bunny trail. Look at him stop and listen to him say.
Celebrities come from all over the world to visit Walt Disney World, and they get lots of oohs, ahs. But here today are the real celebrities of this parade, the royalty of Rabbit Land, Mr. and Mrs. Easter Bunny. Now, I want you to notice, Robby, that she's wearing a 3-carat ring.
Dressed like a dream, your spirit seemed to turn around. That Sunday shine is a certain sign that you feel as fine as you look. Beneath your parasol, the world is all a smile that makes you feel brand new down to your toes. Get out your feathers, your patent leathers, your beads and buckles.
Imagine suggesting that to friends or to your kids today. Take an old-fashioned walk? What's the matter? Your VCR broke down?
Let's roll back the time clock and sit back to enjoy one of the loveliest scenes in our parade as families take an old-fashioned stroll.
Mothers, fathers, kids, nannies, even two small fries and baby buggies all dressed up in their Sunday best. I wish I was out there, don't you, Robby?
You know, one of the greatest sights here today is just watching the kids having so much fun.
Yeah.
And Alicia, did you have a great time on Easter when you were young?
Oh, you bet I did. You know, I grew up in El Paso with two brothers and a sister. And on Easter Sunday, my mother would dress us up in our Sunday best, and we'd go over to my Uncle Joe's to hunt for Easter eggs. Oh, by the way, his daughter, my cousin Mary Elizabeth, works right here. Anyway, we used to have a great time, except my mother was very strict, and she made us eat every egg that we found in the Easter hunt. Oh.
Ah, Susan, thousands of people out here enjoying a spring day, beautiful spring day. Lily Dache, the famous designer, once said, glamour is what makes a man ask for your telephone number.
Oui, but you see, real glamour makes other women ask, where did you get that dress?
And that's probably what's happening all over the country as people parade and show off their Easter finery.
So we'll take our cameras along to admire some bright new American summer fashions featured this year by JCPenney. So join us for a little window shopping.
Yes, and it's the best kind because it's Sunday and most of the stores are closed, and that means that you can't spend money.
Well, we're going to see three girls in a fountain, maybe pick up a hot dog or two, meet a horse wearing an Easter bonnet.
Hey, don't they all? And we'll play New York's favorite street game, taxi, taxi, taxi.
Now, we're not going to start downtown. We're going to start up.
Yeah, it's what you call high fashion.
Hello. Hi. Up there.
Hello up there.
Hi, we're coming up.
Uh-huh.
We want to come up and see you.
You bet.
Offer her some tea.
Please.
There we go. There we go. Yeah. Oh, how about a spot of tea? But careful, please. No spots on American designer Lee Wright's award-winning sports jacket with slate gray shirt and trousers. Mm.
You know, Kenny, diamonds truly are a girl's best friend, especially in Halston 3's blouse with a pink print skirt of crepe de chine. Sensational.
Smart. She turned that sandwich down, Susan.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Happy Easter.
Happy Easter. A new game called Passing the Balloons.
Her new rose blazer and skirt has inverted pleating and a button-down blouse with matching skirt.
And his Cham's cotton blend jacket and cottonwood pants is the real me.
That boy is gonna go far.
Women jockeys, of course, and their clothes are so smart.
The in-the-mood red dress turns day into night, great for all occasions. How about that yellow silk with dropped waist and flared sleeves by Nalani?
The men's suits, they do double duty. All business during the day, all fun at night.
Promises, promises.
Large legs. Whoa. My, that's Alice in Wonderland in the window.
Yeah, and the little girls are wearing Nana's pet dresses in Easter egg colors with ruffle trim.
Where's Mom?
Where's she coming?
There's Mom in a smart Laura Henson suit with cream blouse.
Bye-bye.
Ah, lovely young girl with heart in the Highlands.
Two hot dogs? What a striking outfit she's wearing. Mary McFadden's candy-striped oversized jacket with coordinating royal blue camp shirt and skirt.
One hot dog, two hot dogs, hat, hot dogs, hat, gee.
Mmm, that's a bargain.
In this parade, everybody has an Easter bonnet, even the horse.
Huh? Look at that, he is nodding his approval of those clothes. It's a beautiful beige floral cotton camp shirt teamed with coordinating skirt in blue.
I like his Alan Fusser plaid shirt with the pleated cotton trousers. Now, that's just right for my next polo match.
Right.
Now, Susan, what do you think that horse is thinking?
Well, besides the hat, I haven't got a thing to wear.
No, I tell you what he's saying. You know, I love my hat, but is the feet bag going to fit over this? Tiptoeing through the tulips on Fifth Avenue.
Aha, uh-huh. And there are large blooming flowers on Jennifer's puff sleeve dress.
I like Doug's tough detective look blazer, yellow t-shirt, khaki pants.
Uh-huh.
And if I wore that, I'd put a hanky in the pocket.
Cliff Barnes is a class act.
Uh-huh.
Bye, Jennifer.
Here's a new version of a great old hit song, Three Girls in the Fountain, to coin a phrase.
I was afraid you were going to say that. A trio in Halston 3. Linen blazer with pants, cotton polo sweater with black trousers and long tube skirt and oversized cardigan.
Ah, they're falling for me. Taxi, taxi, taxi.
Oh, well, in the meantime, there's a lovely green silk look dress and a deep pink figure flattering outfit. And Jerry looks great in that Edgewood suit.
Well, fine, because he's probably going to be walking home. Alone? Taxi. Oh, Marilyn Monroe, boy, George.
The Easter Parade. Here on Fifth Avenue, there's the Statue of Liberty.
Another, yeah.
Yeah. Do you know that this parade has a really long tradition? It's going back before the turn of the century. But how did it all get started?
Well, there's one New York historian that claims that after the services at St. Patrick's Cathedral and the other churches on Fifth Avenue, people used to walk out and they would take their flowers to patients in nearby hospitals.
That's great. That's
nice,
the real spirit of what this day is all about.
Yeah.
And you know what? It's great for Ken and me to help carry on another tradition with our second annual CBS Easter Parade.
Be sure, stay tuned. We'll be back with beautiful sights and big surprises. Ken Kercheval with Susan Howard right here at the Easter Parade, CBS.
Yeah, I'm having a great time, aren't you?
Yeah, great time.
That's a dream come
yep.
true. Wait a minute, do you need a shave?
Why? 5 o'clock?
Well, you can always go down to Walt Disney World where they have a barber shop that makes house calls. The five most famous ducks ever to take to water. And our very, very most favorite fairy tale heroine, Alice in Wonderland.
Yes, well, I would love to see a barbershop that makes house calls. Five famous ducks, and I'm simply crazy about Alice in Wonderland.
Well, then let's go on down to the Walt Disney World Parade. Let's go.
From Fifth Avenue, New York, to Main Street in the Magic Kingdom.
And Alicia, I love your Easter hat.
Oh, thanks, Robby. I love your outfit.
Yeah, thanks. Actually, this is Carla DeVito, my wife.
Well, she's one lucky lady. I mean, most husbands would be settled for a snapshot in the pocket, you know?
Well, actually, this is the back cover of Carla's new album that's coming out in April. But Carla couldn't be here. Neither could my little girl named Lyric, so... Hi, Lyric. Hi, Carla. I love you.
Hi, Lyric. Hi, Carla. We love you. Now back to the parade. Always a big hit with the visitors. One of America's outstanding barbershop quartets, the Dapper Dans.
Fly your rose, I'm home again, rose, to get the sun back in my sky. bows and kisses shy. Ding dong ding, I can hear the chapel bells chime. I want a girl just like the girl that met me, dear old Ned, old Ned. She was a pearl and the only girl that daddy ever had. A good old-fashioned girl with heart so true.
Duck takes to the water, as the old saying goes. But in bathing suits, we'll have coats. Because these are the most famous ducks in show business. And they have their own high-fashion swimming costumes.
Huey, Dewey, and Louie.
Yeah. Now, I want everybody to honk. If you think these suits aren't what they're quacked up to be.
Quack. Hot.
Donald and Daisy Duck. I wonder what they're saying to each other.
Oh, he's saying your skirt's too short. No, your bed
is
too short.
He's saying. My baby loves when I do that.
They are cute, though, aren't they?
Yeah, but my baby loves anything I do.
And what would Easter be without a visit to the hat shop? These aren't just ordinary customers, but pretty parasol girls backed up by dancers from the Diamond Horseshoe Review.
Wow. I'll take a dozen of each. Hats, that is.
Oh, of course.
When they put Alice in Wonderland in this parade, they really mean Wonderland with a capital W. First comes the huge teapot steaming along under its own power. And there, look. There's Alice sitting on a giant mushroom. Man, that mushroom must be big enough to keep us in soup all year. Then we have those strange characters from her wild trip through the looking glass. Now, you know, Aunt Alicia, if they remake the movie, maybe we could help cast it, okay? Now, let's see. The Mad Hatter.
Steve Martin.
Very good, okay. The March Hare.
Woody Allen, I mean, he's got no hair. Well, I mean, he's got little hair.
Wait a minute. He's my idol.
My idol, too.
Okay, the White Rabbit.
Joan Rivers, of course.
Definitely. And, of course, there's Tweedledee and Tweedledum.
Ed McMahon and Johnny Carson. Now, I saw how excited you got when you saw Alice in Wonderland. Wow, look at that. Gosh, it looks really cute.
This must be what it looks like from a little kid's perspective.
That is true. That's true.
A parade without popcorn, oh, right?
Thanks, Robby. You know, you're a very clever young man. You can jog, you can dance, you can swim, but here's one thing I'll bet you can't do.
What's that?
Talk while you're eating popcorn.
Oh, that's my forte. We'll be back right after a short break.
That was pretty good.
You know, the great thing about our CBS Easter Parade is that people not only walk, jog, and push baby, but... Look in there, Kenny. Here's a couple on a bicycle built for two.
They sure are. Okay, they're off their bike. Okay, now they're going to do an act called cutting down the tree.
Oh, boy. They're sizing it up.
Yeah.
Green, yeah. Oh, there she goes. She's doing good.
This is Tim Bennett and Lynn Vox. And they're opening Wednesday in a new off-Broadway show called Buskers. Uh-huh. I know about off-Broadway and off-off-Broadway and off-off-off-off. I think that's California.
Texas. Uh-huh. They're going to work together on this one. Oh, they're...
That's grand.
Saw for two.
They're clever. No.
No.
Not ready.
They are. They're going to push the tree down. Now they're going... That's a rope.
Oh, they're
going
to pull it down.
Way up to the top. Okay. Good idea.
Wow, they are clever. That's not it. That's not the answer. What's the answer?
Well, they'll just lean against it.
Timber!
Oh, everybody, let's give these guys a hand.
Give them a hand. That's grand.
That's great.
Hey,
thank you.
Susan,
thank you.
Susan, let me tell you, I do mime too. Watch this, watch this. You know what this is?
Okay, let me see. Wait a minute. I know what that is.
What is it? Tell me what it
is. It's Ken Kercheval's Old Capital Popcorn.
Oh, yes, it is.
Hello.
All right. Here, tell us about your hat.
This is a hat built for two, and it's a Big Apple hat. And it is because this is the greatest city in the world, and we love New York.
Oh, look at that.
Hey, and we love you.
This is Candace and William Red, and they're from Brooklyn. And it's a marvelous hat.
I think this is the first time we've had a couple do something.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Aha. Here's another husband and wife team.
Okay.
It's a totem pole hat. It's designed and worn by the artist.
Jose Feliciano.
Karina Nielsen. It's New York Bronx Botanical Garden.
It certainly is.
Do they know it's gone?
And this is, this is totems of Bronx pride.
Okay. I know this was made out of milk cartons, yes?
Yes, it is. And it's double tape.
It's a lovely job.
Step up here a little.
It's beautiful.
It really is. I think Kenny said tomorrow all the kids in New York are going to be making totem poles out of milk
cartons. Every third grade class.
I'm an artist, and that's what I used to teach them, to do this.
Thank you both very much. Happy Easter. Bye.
Okay.
Okay. This is Michael Levinson. He is an art director in Manhattan, and his hat is topped with the...
This is the Duchess Bethany Jill.
And she has a nose like I've never seen.
She was had it fixed already. Dr. Diamond took good care of it.
Oh, my.
I hope it wasn't a friend.
Oh, no.
That's a grand hat.
This was created by the artist Noel McFetrich.
Thank you very much.
It's grand. Thank you.
Happy Easter.
You. Next, Karina Nielsen Feliciano.
Joe's wife is, wait a minute. Is this right? No, that's not right. Hendrix, is that right?
I'm Marguerite Hendrix from Springfield Gardens, New York.
And you're a retired milliner?
That's correct.
Tell us about your hat.
Well, you have here your palm tree, and the palm tree makes the basket and twine. And the Mexican is wishing Texas and New York a happy Easter.
So we have an Easter greeting from Mexico.
All right.
How do you say happy Easter in Mexico?
Happy Easter in New York style.
Ah! It's very pretty,
grand.
Really. Thank you.
Okay.
Well, where's
great
your
hats.
Hat?
Huh? My hat? I don't have a hat. I should have a hat.
You like mine?
I love your
hat. It was designed for me by a person right here in New York City.
Was it really?
Yep.
It's beautiful.
Thank you.
It's beautiful. We'll be back.
Yeah.
8:10. Yeah.
Looky, there's a man dressed like a bunny.
There is a bunny. I can't see him.
Oh, look, he's waving at us. Hi.
Oh, hi.
He is a
Harvey?
Fuzzy bunny.
Is it Harvey?
Do you know there are 100,000 people on that street?
Such a beautiful, beautiful day.
It is.
This is fun.
It's a perfect
gorgeous
Easter day.
I heard we might set a record for this day, for
yes.
Easter on this day.
Do you know
day.
What the record is?
Yeah.
What?
80.
No.
No, 79. Yeah, okay.
You know, there's Godzilla the iguana, Inca the llama. Sounds like exotic creatures from a far-off land, huh?
Yeah, it does. Actually, they're native New Yorkers, and to find them, we just have to move north along Fifth Avenue to Central Park,
and find one of the city's most charming and popular attractions, the Children's Zoo.
And what a charming place it is, in the shadows of tall buildings and fancy condominiums, just a few feet from the bustling city street, not far from a noisy subway, a lovely little oasis of very friendly animals.
Yep, pigs and geese and donkeys and Abner the goat and a parrot that sings opera and John Denver songs.
What's wrong with John Denver?
Nothing. Parrot loves him.
Well, and while we're there, we'll get another chance to admire more of those American-style fashions from JCPenney.
Out of Africa?
No, Children's Zoo. What a great place to take the family.
Yeah, Mom's wearing Injun red camp shirt, chino pants by Lee Wright.
Like father, like son, polo shirts, khaki socks. Mm-hmm.
Jennifer, a T-top, red and tan elephants.
No peanuts.
Oh.
Now, out of the rabbit tunnel, Joey in blue pants and T-top from JCPenney. That shows he's a Sesame Street sport.
Right behind is Jennifer. She's got a thing for Big Bird and Friends, T-shirt and pink pants. And how about those overalls, kissed with hearts?
They're cute, aren't they? Jennifer, watch out, baby.
There they go. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Question.
Good.
What do you wear to have lunch with a llama?
Well, Melissa and Robin have on cotton knit jumpsuits by Punch Cool.
I like Doug's plaid shirt by Exploits and gray pleated trousers.
Mm-hmm. But let me ask you, what happens when they stop with the food?
It's in New York. Sends out to the deli.
Deli.
Deli Lama.
You know, a good time to come to Noah's Ark before all the animals arrive. See? Looky here. Mom's dressed for it with a knit sweater and turquoise pants by Mary McFadden. The girls have fun printed overalls.
Joey's all set with gray poplin slacks and striped knit top. Listen to this. I know it's stretching the point, but you know, looks like this guy's outfit went through the roof. Three little pigs and Melissa and Robin ready to try the blow your house down bit.
Yeah, they're all dressed for it, all right. Crop tops and slim leggings by American designer Trebigo.
Oh, nice try, girls. They just don't huff like that anymore.
You know, Kenny, it's amazing what turns some people on. Feeding a whale.
I just don't see the porpoise of it. Hmm? Got to reread all they did. Famous gingerbread condo?
Yeah, Melissa's dressed up in a candy striped top with matching skirt.
Melissa, be careful. Remember the wicked old witch?
Oh, but this story's new. Handsome Doug in aqua blue shirt and white jeans.
And they live stylishly ever after.
Amen. And dressed in fine fashion is Myla. Cool and casual in a cotton sweater with skirt.
I like Jerry's blue-striped polo shirt and navy pants by par four. Of course, golf for me, it's more like par eight.
And Jennifer's aqua-printed pant and top set is ideal.
Well, if you want to get somebody's goat in New York, you've just got to go to the Children's Zoo.
Yeah.
Bah.
Nah.
Nah.
Very good.
Thank you.
Ah, look at all those hats out there. The strong
hats,
the bowlers.
They're sailor hats.
They are.
That's what they're called, sailor hats.
I didn't know that. You know, Kenny, talking about all those people out there, it's really a great day for families. And everybody really likes to sit around and tell their favorite Easter story, because we've all got them. What's yours?
Mine?
Yeah.
About my Easters? Oh, they were great, yeah. Would you believe, now this is true, okay. 1 year my dad and I had identical suits. Now that was pre-teen years for me, I have to tell you. And then my sister and I, we'd dye Easter eggs and put those decals on the eggs and all over our arms and all that sort of thing. There was always one unfound egg that was discovered like a couple weeks later by our noses. Huh?
Yes, I had some of those myself, right?
Well...
You are looking at Fifth Avenue. Isn't that neat?
Beautiful.
Uh-huh. I'm glad to be a part of it. Okay, can I ask you to do something for me? Would you hold this for me?
Sure.
I have something I really want to do.
Okay.
I want to say to all of my hearing impaired friends, Happy Easter. I love you. Hi, Solomon.
Oh, God bless you, Susan. That was lovely.
Thanks.
That was lovely.
You know, can they say that if you stand long enough right here on Fifth Avenue that you'll meet everybody in America who is somebody?
Okay. Let's try it, huh? Let's see what happens. We'll just wait and see what happens.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Okay. Hello. Are you somebody?
Oh, hi.
Here we go.
I think I know who you are.
Yeah.
Okay. You are Brian Schumann.
That's right.
you designed all these hats.
I did.
Tell me about them.
Okay, well, right here we have what's called a mouse head. It's when the farmer's away, the mice will play. Then we have a rose trellis hat. And far over there we have Easter Sunday in the park.
Now, I do know that these are all your family, your mom and your two sisters, right?
Right. There's Audrey, Johanna, my mother, and Kara.
Okay, let's do one hat at a time. Start with a glider.
Okay. Well, there's a swing on that hat, right? And that's just a garden, you know, with benches and a little chick up there.
Okay, now then tell us about the trellis.
Okay, there's the rose trellis. It has birds and a little door.
And now the mouse hat.
Okay. And there's little mice here. They're just running around all over the hat. And
very beautiful. Praise the Lord.
Thank you. Happy Easter.
You.
Thank you very much. All right.
Aha. Now I know this. This is Vicky Belmonte, and I think it means beautiful mountain in Italian. Tell us about your hat.
It does. This is Hallie's Comet. The crown is blue, and the netting is white, and we've got the comet in gold sequins, and it's surrounded by multicolored shooting stars. Quite different for me. I don't wear this in nonsense.
Oh, yes, you're in nonsense, off-Broadway.
Yes, Dan.
Yes.
Thank you, Vicky. Happy Easter.
You too. It's wonderful.
Okay, thank you. All right. Next, we have Juana Sands from Perth Amboy, New Jersey.
Hello,
and she has a tropical hat. Tell us about it.
This hat is, it represents a fisherman's boat with a net dragging a lot of seashells, including a giant oyster bait.
Here, turn around. Let's see this boat. It's a lovely boat, Puerto Rico.
I want you to let him see those coils up there.
And pearls in the shells. How nice it would be. Thank you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Now the next is Liz Samulk. She is from Asbury, New Jersey, where she works as an independent designer.
Thank you. Yes, I've made a wire and a silk, hand-painted silk construction in the form of an ornament, which can also be hung on the wall when you're not wearing it.
And you also designed this dress.
Yes.
It's lovely.
Thank you.
The black orchid. How nice. Next is Dorothy Bartlett, who hails from St. Albans, Queens. And Dorothy's hat is designed by Marguerite Hendricks.
This is a replica of the Brooklyn Bridge. As you can see, we have people, cars, everything on top.
Traffic slowed down today.
And a little bit of Easter in there also.
That's lovely. Wow. Everything.
I even see Mickey Mouse over here on the side. Turn around.
Mickey Mouse, an old Ford car. Oh, that's super. An airplane. Okay, thank you very much.
Happy Easter. Next is Mary Lou Kyla. She's wearing a very special Easter hat. Tell us about it.
This is a Noel McFetridge creation, Henrietta the Chicken.
Do you do sound effects with it?
No, I don't. Last year it was hooked up to some chicken sounds, but...
Is there an egg missing?
Yes, I dropped an egg on the way here today.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Really.
Thank you very
Happy
much.
Happy Easter, everyone.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Next, we have Juanita Fauntleroy. She's a retired Sears manager from Queens.
Happy Easter. And this is the World's Trade Center designed by fabulous Dorian Corey.
That's super. High-flying
Thank
birds.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Happy Easter.
Millie Vassell is a housewife from Queens. Tell us about your hat.
Well, my hat, I'll be eating it for dinner tonight.
Eating it for dinner? And his name's JR?
Yes.
Good. Eat him.
We
eat
like
him.
That.
Definitely. Eat
Happy
him.
Easter.
Okay. Thank you so much. Well, that's it. Easter 1986. Tell me, Susan, how was your Easter growing up in East Texas, huh?
You mean Marshall, Texas?
Marshall. I've been there.
Yeah. It was really great. This outfit, like I'm wearing today, was very important because we would spend a month and a half really figuring out what we were going to wear. It was very special. We'd go to church. We'd come home, have a real big dinner, and then we'd have an Easter egg hunt, and we'd all go look at the dogwoods all afternoon.
Oh, it sounds so lovely. Great, isn't it? It's great how the Easter spirit and those memories stay with us year after year.
We'll be right back.
Well, we've met a lot of our favorite Disney characters today.
Yeah, Pinocchio, Pluto, Snow White. Snow White, you know, after all these years, I wonder how she keeps her hair so black.
Yeah, but you gotta remember that these are like fictional characters. I mean, they don't have the same problems that real actors have. You know, like memorizing long scripts.
And new hairdos, costume fittings.
Yeah. But you know what? I think I may have the answer to this. Maybe we should get some animators, and they can make us into cartoon characters. You know?
Oh, no.
I think that needs a lot of work.
Well, we'll figure it out later, but let's get back to the parade, okay?
All right. You may be wondering why these people are riding big farm horses. Well, these happen to be one of the world's most famous breeds. They're called Percherons. And they're called that because they come from a French region of La Perche.
It's true. Percherons have pulled stagecoaches and heavy wagons. They're most famous as circus horses, even dancing and rolling the barrel.
Yeah, and usually you see them gallop around the ring with acrobats performing on their backs. And to provide a firmer foothold, they dust them with powder. So the circus folks call them rosinbacks. And they're really beautiful, too.
I love horses. Look at him.
He's great. Yeah.
Here's the hay wagon, but what it's hauling ain't hay. It's the Country Fair Jamboree, a popular group of down-home musicians, Wendell, Shaker, Liverlip, and Big Al.
Yeah, they're my baby's favorite.
Well, they're in a wagon, and maybe that's the only way they can carry a tune. I like Liverlip. He's my favorite.
Is that why you like me?
Here's a favorite Disney cartoon character, Clara Cluck. From the top of the chicken coop. But fellas, get ready for the cutest clutch of charming chickens ever the clock had.
Yeah, and they can really dance, too. Patat, swing, sway, strut, and kick. They're the barnyard's answer to the Rockettes.
Working 9 to 5.
There's my mom, Robbie. Doesn't she look beautiful? She's sitting here with me watching the parade.
She's gorgeous. But that's my mother.
Wait a minute. No, that's my mother. Anybody not familiar with the story of Cinderella must have just landed from outer space.
But I'll bet you've never seen it told more beautifully.
Lovely Cinderella riding in a sparkling crystal coach pulled by white ponies. Oh, look at that coach. That is just spectacular. And here comes Cinderella.
And how's this for a grand finale? Beautiful girls in gorgeous old-fashioned gowns.
They look beautiful. God, I'm such an old-fashioned girl, and I love those periods of time, don't you? I mean, all the romance and everything.
I love romance, but I like them with a modern woman. Oh, there's a
Well, meet the most recognized couple in the world. Here are Mickey and Minnie Mouse. The fascinating news is that this will be a banner here in Mouseton, especially for Minnie.
That's right. She's gonna have a dazzling new look. It's called Totally Minnie.
Ooh. Watch out. Well, you know, it's really been great working with you, Aunt Alicia, and I hope that you and your mom, Alicia, just have a wonderful holiday. Oh, thank you. It's really a joy knowing you, and I hope next time we get together that I get to meet your beautiful daughter, Lyric.
I hope so. Thanks. Well, as they say in California, have a good day. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
3, 2.
Happy Easter, everybody.
Empire State Building.
And I have it on good authority that King Kong has just left and is on his way down here now that we can interview him.
Oh, really? Well, we're winding up here. It's great Easter, isn't it? And it's great how those memories stay with us year after year, and look at all the people out here.
Now I'm going to tell you what. This is a memory that I will have. I really enjoyed working with you.
Likewise. Thank you. I love you, dear.
Okay, now then. This is a question for Cliff Barnes.
Yes.
Tell me, Donna Krebs, when are you going to get J.R. Ewing?
Next Friday.
Hallelujah.
Now, I want you to meet some of my family. Ava Fox, my fiance, my daughter Liza, and I want to say Happy Easter. Mom, Aaron, Caleb, their wives, Kate, Shelley, Ruth, Lynn, Chuck, Don, I could go on, so I'm going to give it over to Susan here.
And I want you all to welcome the love of my life, my husband, Calvin Crane. I want to say Happy Easter to my mother, Peg Mooney, to my grandmother, little old Granny Mooney, to Elvis and Gwen, to my daughter, Lynn, to Paul and David, and to everybody out there. Really, God bless you all, and we love being here with you today.
All right. Well, I think it's marvelous. This is our way and CBS's way of saying to you, Happy Easter.
We hope we can do a third and a fourth and a fifth and a sixth, and more and more people will show up here.
It's been a marvelous hour.
Yeah.
Look at all these marvelous people. Let's have all of these people say Happy Easter with us.
Okay.
Everybody.
We're going to do a...
We're going to wave.
Come
and
on.
Say,
to that, people.
Ready? Happy Easter.
Okay. One.
Happy Easter.
We hope you enjoy the second annual Easter Parade, a Nabisco Brands presentation. Nabisco, a family of fine products, premium saltines, almost home cookies, Lifesavers candies, Oreo cookies, and Ritz crackers. Quality for as long as you can remember. So long, and Happy Easter from all of us to all of you.